Evening, Edgar. Could I get your professional opinion?
Please speak, but I have something important to tell you.
This strain of flu, it's very different from the one I saw in Europe. It's downright peculiar.
Really? What makes you say that?
I've just looked at the blood of one of our recently deceased.
I see. Do you have anything more to go on?
This disease spreads and looks like the Spanish flu, but its effects differ greatly. The London strain is different from the continental one.
This is very interesting. Did you find something else?
Yes. Unlike the flu, the infected begin to show an increase in outwardly aggressive behavior. More than simple agitation. Once docile people become violent.
You mean like rabies? Is there a chance we could create a vaccine, Jonathan, like Pasteur? By the stove, that would be smashing.
There's a lot we're not seeing here, but it is spreading, and quickly. If we don't act, the whole city could be lost.
But Jonathan, we've a fantastic opportunity sitting right here in front of us. A weapon of choice.
What on earth do you mean?
Why, you, my dear boy! With your expertise and your blood, we could isolate the properties that course through your veins. Think about the possibilities.
And why not? What did Stoker say about the children of the night? Well, using my blood, I could create a whole army of vampires.
Surely you're joking.
We'll discuss this more later. Thank you for your time.
No, thank you, Jonathan. But as I said, I needed to talk to you. I have some rather bad news.
Yes?
I'm afraid it's your sister.
My sister?
She's to be buried this evening at Whitechapel Cemetery. Your mother published the obituary this morning.
I see.
I'm sorry, Jonathan. Please accept my condolences.
I never thought I would have to attend my murdered sister's funeral. Mary, I can't forgive myself. I'll find the truth about what happened to us. I swear. My dear sister, I don't know if I have the strength. It's locked. Are you all right, miss?
I don't know. Who were those people? They wanted to kill me. Why?
They've lost their minds in the epidemic. They won't come back for now.
You seem to know a lot about them, sir.
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. I'm investigating this disease.
I am Xiao Xun. Thank you so much for helping me, Mr. Reed. I must go to the cemetery now. Goodbye. Since I can't reveal myself to my mother now, I must find a discreet spot to attend the ceremony.
I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. We commend unto thy hands of mercy, most merciful Father. The soul of our sister departed, and we commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Why kill my Mary and stick her here in this cold, god-awful place?
These are the legal requirements for the epidemic, madam.
Oh, Avery, I feel so tired. Please take me home.
Yes, madam.
Could only change This is a nightmare.
Jonathan, there is nothing you can do but accept it.
What brings you here?
I thought you could use the company. I am so sorry for your loss, Jonathan.
She was a good person. Vibrant, full of life. She was kindness incarnate, my Mary.
You're a good person, Jonathan. And a young Ekon. A newborn cast into the night without so much as a candle to guide your way.
She had been scouring the most dangerous parts of London in search of me. And it led to her death.
Jonathan, don't.
I still hear her last thoughts. They echo in my head. Her mind shattered. And it haunts me.
Jonathan, stop. Listen carefully. You must come to terms with this. You must learn to live with what happened.
How is it possible? Tell me. Is it so easy to take a life every night and then just smile and nod at those you spared?
Don't you see? You're doing the work of our enemies, feeding your remorse. We are weakest when we grieve, and the guilt blurs our senses.
And so this is why you're here. To warn me. You felt this pain yourself. You too have endured this.